The shocking statistic is 30,000 people will hear those words, you've got cancer. That's one person every 15 minutes in Ireland today. With Shave or Die, we're there with them every step of the way.
Jill came up with the notion that, look, there's one big thing that affects everybody in the country in some shape or form, and that's cancer.
No matter what difficulties we may be having at the moment, with recession, all the rest of it, when it comes to it, Irish people will dig in their pockets and they'll help each other out.
He's raised over €5,000, so...
It's amazing how generous everybody is.
Yeah,
Thank you to everyone who sponsored me.
Fantastic.
Really appreciate it.
I think every family, every person has been touched in some way by cancer with a relative or a friend or whatever. So I think that's probably why everybody is giving so generously closer to home, you know?
3, 2, 1.
Awesome. I was diagnosed with cancer 5 years ago, and Shave or Die is 5 year anniversary, so I'm here to say that I'm alive, I'm well, and I'm here to shave your hair.
I can't be talking to you, I'm doing this at the same time.
Yeah, I'm here for Shave or Die. It is a fight as well, and I like the idea of it being a war against something that's literally been destroying the country for years. So yeah, it's a real good positive step.
Sadly, a young sister of mine died of cancer some time back, and therefore any charity that's to do with cancer, I always want to help. Maybe some year I'll get it shaved, but it mightn't look so great on prime time. But hey, could be a whole new look.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are Record Breakers!
I've both been affected by cancer in my own family, as well as a lot of lads on our unit.
You know, a group of colleagues really fighting together to try and obliterate cancer. That's our aim.
My mother-in-law, she died of cancer there back in two, three years ago. So Ellis is actually the one that's getting the mohawk done today, so he is.
Get a Mohican, join a world record attempt, you know, have a coffee. Somebody said something earlier on about just making younger people and children just aware of it, so they're not, you know, it's a less frightening thing. And I think even if you achieve that, is the most important thing.
As a Shave or Die, we have a generation now who've grown up with it. They know that about cancer from their teenage years, they're not afraid to talk about it.
It's my daughter Ella. Ella unfortunately was diagnosed with cancer when she was 7 months old. Luckily she got better, and I decided that because we got great help from the Irish Cancer Society and the Hospital Crumlin, that we would just give something back.
We have to raise 20 million every year to deliver this free services and to fund the research that we do. And it's people all over the country. That's the great thing about the work we do with Shave or Die, and we're able to help people right throughout Ireland.
It was great for the community. It's done so much more than just raise money for cancer.
Every year we're amazed by the amount of people getting involved. We'd love people to do it again. We would love new people to get involved. It's more important than ever that the money is raised and the research is done. So we do need people to get involved in Shave or Die this year.
We're hoping 2015 will be the biggest yet. And with your help, we just might be able to make that happen.
We hope that you're going to get involved again in what should be another fantastic year of community involvement that this station promotes for Shave or Die.
7.5 million so far and still rising. It's just fantastic. So thanks a million, and hopefully we'll see you for Shave or Die 2015.